Hey, what's up? This is Mikey at Blue Monkey Bicycles, and in this video, we're going to take a look at the Shimano e8000 mid-drive motor.
Yeah, I've been waiting for this.
In case you didn't know, here it is. The motor disassembly for this particular motor was done by an electrical professional in a controlled environment. Any tampering or trying to open the motor on the customer end is going to void the warranty instantly. It may risk personal injury, and it very well could destroy the entire system while you're goofing around with it. All the warranty work and service work should be done by a competent professional, such as the place that you got the bike from in the first place. So, anyways, now that that's out of the way, let's jump in. Shimano is a household name in the bike industry, as well as, well, pretty much any household that has a bicycle. There's a good chance that you have Shimano parts on it, as Shimano makes components for bicycles at all sorts of different price points. So yeah, it wasn't until recently though that they came out in the United States with an electric drive system, the e6000. Now the e6000 is kind of boxy, a little big, and in my opinion, tiny bit noisy, but I still like it nonetheless. I use it on a light duty cargo bike that I personally use with my little Sweet Pea. Aww. But it wasn't really ready for the rough and tumble rigors of mountain bike use. And as a matter of fact, there was no electric Shimano system on a mountain bike until now. This is the new Shimano e8000 mid-drive motor. Shimano is blazing a trail with one of the lightest, most natural mid-drive motors on the market today. Let's jump into the specs. Okay, easy stuff first. It's a 250-watt mid-drive motor capable of a 36-volt system and a 20-mile-an-hour top speed, which is par for the course. Cadence, torque, and speed sensors throughout the system provide excellent responsive riding and caps out at a maximum assist level of 300% power output from the motor. Shimano doesn't specify the top RPMs that the motor will assist to, but I am told, quote, "Let's just say I have not met anyone who has maxed it out yet." No. Time will tell. Rocking 70 Newton meters of instant torque, the e8000 has three levels of pedal assist: Eco, Trail, and Boost. Now you might be thinking to yourself, other systems have four or five levels of pedal assist, so what gives? Why only three? Well, let me tell you. The assist modes on the e8000 are tunable in the Shimano software called eTube. This means that after getting used to the system, the owner can have the motor output customized to fine-tune the experience. As far as I know, Shimano is the only company to offer this option, and when I get my hands on one, I'm totally going to fiddle with it and I'm going to max it out and make it just... Shimano does have their own battery that is available with the entire system. The standard battery is a 36-volt, 14-amp-hour battery mounted on top of the down tube. Now, I've seen pictures of an integrated battery from Shimano. Maybe that's a European thing. I haven't seen one yet. Also, be aware that sometimes other bike companies will use a different battery with the Shimano motor. For example, Bulls has an electric bike with a different battery on it that is not covered by Shimano. I'm sure it's a good battery and everything, but if you want everything to be under one roof, be aware that sometimes you might come into that. Of special note, the motor weighs in at 2.8 kilograms, which is actually the lightest of all the electric bike motors in its class. For you bike guys, the Q factor comes in at 177 millimeters. They also have what they call dynamic chain engagement, which means the tooth profile is designed to provide, quote, superior chain retention, lower driving noise, and increased durability. Other cool features of the motor is the physical size of it, which I measured to come in at 8 inches long, 5 inches tall, and 4 inches wide, aside from the spindle, of course. The lower weight and the smaller physical size of the motor can really help when the motor is oriented on the bike in a way to provide awesome tire clearance, such as on a dual suspension mountain bike. Speaking of that, you can get the Pedego Elevate, a Shimano e8000 equipped dual suspension mountain bike from BlueMonkeyBicycles.com. If you go to our website and shop there, you can get the bike sent straight to your door. And you can partake in awesome resources that are available only to Blue Monkey Bicycle customers, such as an assembly video, how to use the display, and other fun stuff like that. Big thanks to Shimano USA for providing the motor that we use to illustrate in this video. Thank you very, very much. If you want to learn more about the Shimano Step system, go to www.shimano-steps.com/e-bikes/North-America/EN. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to check out more upcoming videos, such as the range test video where I'm going to be putting rubber to the road on the e8000 to test out how it feels and how far the bike goes on full blast with a standard battery. I'll be doing more tests such as that and the PWX motor from Yamaha in the very near future. I'll be comparing these two motors alongside the German competitors, the Bosch CX and the Brose S, in a big mashup video that you'll be seeing in the near future. So yeah, subscribe to the channel, shop on our website, and like, comment, subscribe, and thanks again for watching this spotlight on the Shimano e8000. I'll see you guys on the later.